गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी वर स्टडिंग अबाउट द इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ह्यूमन हार्ट इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर. नाउ आफ्टर द कंप्लीटिंग ऑफ दैट टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द डबल सर्कुलेशन. यस स्टूडेंट्स, डबल सर्कुलेशन. What is double circulation? We just going to discuss about this type of circulation of the blood in human body in this video lecture. Students, for your kind information, the circulation of blood inside organism body as well as human was first reported by William Harvey. It means William Harvey was the first biologist who discovered the circulation of blood in the body. That's why he is also regarded as the father of blood circulation, or you can say that physiology of circulation of blood. Now in this topic, as the name clear that double circulation, then what is the means of double circulation? Students, here the double circulation means this is the right half of the human body's blood vascular system, that is called RTL, blood vascular system, and this is the left half of the human body's blood circulation system, which is called RTL. RTL is the left. RTL vascular system, or you can say that RTL system. And this is the venous system, because here you clearly visualize about the presence of cellular wall. And students, the presence of these walls these are the characteristics of the presence of vein. So this is the venous system. Is that clear? So in the right half of the body, always flow deoxygenated blood. What type of blood is flow inside the right half of the body? Always deoxygenated blood. It means impure blood. Is that clear? And in left half, there is always flow of oxygenated blood take place. It means pure blood. Understood? So the circulation of the blood in the right half as impure and in the left half as pure, this never mixes. It means the venous blood and the arterial blood never mixes and circulate in their specific direction. This type of the flow of the blood inside our body is known as double circulation. Now going to study in detail. This is the head part, the lungs, where the blood goes for the process of oxygenation. Is that clear? Now this is the heart, and these are the four chambers: right atrium, right ventricle, left atrium and left ventricle. These are the four chamber of the heart. As in internal structure of human heart, what we study? We study the superior vena cava collects the venous blood from four part of the body. Hence, this is the direction of flow of the venous blood, and it first enters into which part of the heart? The right atrium part of the heart. First, the venous blood comes from the whole part of the body. Here you also observe the pulmonary artery. This is the pulmonary artery which carries the oxygenated blood to the lungs, but this venous portal system carries the deoxygenated blood from the upper part of the body, means from the brain, and this also carries, it means the pulmonary artery carries that deoxygenated blood to the lungs. Once again, going to discuss, this is the superior vena cava which almost receives the whole deoxygenated blood from the whole parts of the body, and the first impure blood comes into the right atrium with the help of a tricuspid wall. It further enters into the right ventricle. Now from the right ventricle it goes into the lungs for oxygenation. Thus, after passing into the lungs, the blood becomes oxygenated, and it then appears, or you can say that comes into the left atrium with the help of the pulmonary vein. This is the pulmonary vein. What is that? Pulmonary vein, or you can say left pulmonary vein, as you study in the internal structure of human heart. So this left pulmonary vein branches helps in carrying the oxygenated blood into the left heart. Now from the left heart it distributed from there to the head part of the body, to the upper part of the body, as well also this is the pulmonary vein from the lungs. Here it is lighted and both are the same. So now the oxygenated blood, this is with the help of dorsal aorta. With the help of dorsal aorta, these send to the rest part of the body. And students, one thing you also clearly visualize, there is no cellular valves are present. So these are the arteries. Is that clear? That's why this portal system is called arterial system. Is that clear? As for example, this is the liver, oxygenated blood goes. This is the gut, it means extra all others abdominal part, reproductive or genital part. Especially here the abdominal part are said to be gut. It means it includes stomach, pancreas, duodenum, spleen, small intestine, large intestine, all these commonly called gut. Thus the oxygenated blood enters into the gut. Further it moves towards the liver with the help of hepatic portal vein. This is the hepatic portal vein, and this sends the venous blood to the liver part with the help of this duct, and it further enters into the venous system. Thus, students, and this is the rest part of the body, including lower extremities, it means lower limb or lower legs, as well as the genital part of the body. Is that clear? So what you find here, we observe here the oxygenated blood and the deoxygenated blood. never mixes with one another with this arrangement, and they just continue circulate with the help of the natural pumping machine that is called heart. That's why students, this type of circulation of blood in which the right ventricle and left ventricle, or you can say that right RTM and left RTM, blood never mixes with one another with the help of this bottle system. This is called double circulation system. Once again going to define, in the one half the venous blood circulate, and whereas in the second half the ideal, that is oxygenated or pure blood, is circulated in our body separately, and the deoxygenated blood and oxygenated blood never mixes from one another. This is called double circulation. Is that clear, students? I hope you all of you understand this topic very well, and the related PDF notes is sent to your group. You clearly study, and about if any kind of query, then you can ask with the help of comments in the comment section. Thanks, students, for joining today's lecture.